We are still going with Nostalgia Week. And today on the Chopping Block, we have Inside, one of my favorite games of all time. I've said it before, I put it in my top five. I think it's absolutely incredible. It blew me away the first time I played it, and it kind of changed a lot of what I like aesthetically after I played it, and it just, it's absolutely incredible. Again, if you haven't seen it before, because we're doing Nostalgia Week, you can go back and watch the previous series on it so you're not spoiled on anything. But if you're here and you're watching it again, I assume you either don't care about spoilers or you're here for Nostalgia Week and you're just here to have fun. So let's just get into it. The game just starts. There's nothing else to it. It's not even that long a game. Which is another reason, really good reason to play it, because I think it's just a nice, like, concise experience. I love games like this. As I get older, I have less and less time for, like, 100-hour games. Look, I just don't have time anymore. It's these types of experiences that hit me the hardest now. Being able to run around as a little boy in a really cool forest. I think what surprised me about this game was how good the visuals were. Like, it's a 2D game, but a lot of the rendering techniques they use are really high quality. If people going off in a van or a truck. Oh, and the dude in the background still like searching around. All of these pods. Again, it's that ambiguous, vague type of storytelling that I love. I just think this stuff is phenomenal because your brain does so much work for you. Thinking about so many different things all the time. Like, who am I? Where am I? What am I doing? I guess you could say that about any game. I just love the mystery of this one. And those volumetric lights. No one's here. Yeah, just keep walking. Yep, keep going. There you go. Okay, bye. Because you never get to see what those tubes are attached to. The ones on the tanks. You just don't know where it goes. Hi-ya! God, I'm strong. Uh-oh. Dogs. Dogs are scary. Just seeing the sort of like fog in the distance is really cool. Which is weird, because I played Somerville recently, and a lot of the reviews on Somerville are saying like, oh, it's too vague, you don't really know what's going on. It's kind of boring. Like, all these different things, I'm like, but Somerville and Inside are very similar. At least I think in terms of their storytelling. Maybe people are just more forgiving of this one. Hi! How's it going? Because I loved Limbo. Limbo is the previous game. Oh god, hold on. Oh, this is gonna pucker your ass. Oh god! Oh! I've played this game like 5 times, and I still pucker up every time this happens. Oh, jeez, go away. Like I said, they made Limbo before this one. And Limbo is a great game as well, but it just doesn't have that, like, incredible wow factor that this one had for me. Like, this one blew me away. Limbo was very, very, very good. I love that game. But this one was, like, straight to the top of my favorite games ever. I think just this aesthetic and the type of story that it is and the type of weirdness that it goes and... It's just the type of stuff that I personally am really, really into. Oh, you don't see me. You don't see- Oh, so you can run faster when you want to. You just decide not to. Yikes. No one's here. It's so creepy, like, what was I doing in the forest? Am I one of the people that came from a tube? From a tank? And these people are all looking for any outliers, I guess. You see more of it as you get later into the game about what's going on, but... It's really cool. Oh, look at that light! Oh, look at his light. Oh, God! No! Stranger danger! Leave me alone! Go away! Okay, we're running, we're stopping. We're stopping. You're going, boy. Okay, bye! That guy has a gun! Don't shoot me! I'm just a child! Run! Oh! Thank God you suck at aiming! Oh, the dogs don't, though. Oh, I hate it! Oh, Lord! Sloosh! Oh, even that bubble effect. The way those bubbles dissipate and take forever to do it. Oh, it's incredible! The way the rain comes down, the reflections everywhere. Yes, I know, I'm a sucker for reflections. Reflections in games aren't even that hard to do. But it's just, the reason I like them so much is because it adds depth. Secret. Mm-hmm. Okay, back, forward, inertia, physics. Nice. These things are so weird. So there's multiple of these around the game. And you're, like, until the end, you don't really know what they do. I mean, by the end, you still kind of don't know what's going on 100%. Because that's the way these games are designed. But they're like little nodes. I'm so glad I'm playing this again. This game again. This is one of my comfort games. Like, I'll just play this on a day that I'm feeling bad. Wait, did I get shot? How did you see me? Whoa. Okay. Guess I gotta go further down. I got shot with a tranquilizer. Okay, get some air. But not too much. Just be one with the fish. Eventually you'll learn to breathe underwater and then we won't have to worry about this at all. But I think the main thing that blew me away about this game was how good the sound design was. Because I didn't expect the sound design to be as good as it was. For a 2D game. Like, Limbo had good sound design, but it wasn't like the best ever. This, I'd say, is some of the best sound design in a game. It's subdued, it's important when it's needed. Look at that fog. Oh! Silent Hill! I'm a sucker for good fog. It's adds so much atmosphere to things. Hiya! Through the cornfield. So this is where one of the secrets is. Let me... Can you grab it before... Yeah. So I think I showed this off before in the previous series, but this is like a secret area that you come to at the end of the game. You can just come here and finish the game immediately if you know what this sequence is. But you have to figure out a very specific frequency that plays somewhere else later. And it plays like... Oh no, you can't get in, because you need all of them unlocked to unlock that door. But that's where we're trying to get with all these nodes. These bad boys. And you see that thing right above my head? That's the blob that we get at the end of the game. Now also, I think something else develops as you're here over time, but I can't remember. But that's like a hint of things to come. Like, there's a camera here on the desk. This is obviously a dark room to develop pictures, but... Just adds so much to it. Like, what's going on? Who's doing all this stuff? And... It's like a bunker with all this food. So clearly they're not with the system. With the people. But the first time I played the game, I didn't know that that existed. Did I show it in my playthrough? Maybe I didn't, because I don't know if I knew about it back then. Hey, little chickadees! My friends! Come on, everybody together now. I'll be your new chicken mom. Yes, tweet. It's rainy out here, let's all get inside quickly. They're so cute. So the first thing you see in the game is a pig farm. And that's like, people say that pigs and humans share a lot of our, like, not so much genetic structure, DNA or something, like a lot of what's in pigs is the same as us, so they're good test subjects. So we can test on pigs and it'll kind of show us what it'll do to us in a way. So this is like a test farm, or like a place where they raised pigs so they can test on them. Oh wait, we're going through this. Oh yeah, I've played it 5 times, I know what I'm doing. Come on in, lads, it's nice and dry in here. Alright, everybody in. Oh, you must be so cold, you're so tiny. Alright, this is gonna suck. For you guys. I'm so sorry. Okay, that goes. Push, 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 push. Everybody come over here. Come on, last chick. Come on, end of the pack. Come on. Are you the one that's gonna die? So a lot of this stuff is really symbolic. So you suck these up to like shoot them at the bale of hay. Which, let's face it, in real life, every one of them would die. Every single one of them that went into that would die. But for the game, only this little guy dies on the right. That, or he's just unconscious or completely messed up. But if you notice the sense of, because the whole game is about controlling minds, it's about controlling people, it's about controlling groups. And there's some sort of like meta commentary going on with games and the control I have over the character in the game, and I guess to a bigger extent, the control that you guys might have over my channel and what gets dictated and what you have over the internet. And it's all about different layers of control, and this is kind of like your first sort of foray into seeing what that means, that even though they have free will and they're running around, like, but do they? Because they're just following me blindly and they're going on instinct and I'm the one kind of controlling them. And I use them to get what I need. Like, I use them to progress the puzzle that I need, which becomes a very big theme in the game. Ooh, yellow cable. That means secret. I probably won't get all of them first time through because I forget where they all are. Huh! Pigs. Disgusting. And now you see the worms coming out of the pigs, that like wiggle worm right above my head. So in Limbo, you have worms that go into your head and control you and make you walk in certain directions. So this, I think, the worms are like a primitive form of the mind control. That they're like an early version of what the mind control in this game was, and they were testing it on pigs. They're like, okay, human trials. Or at least, you can see like the connection to it. You can see the steps that they might have gone through to do that. Oof. And in here, you see all the pigs. There's so many of them. It's really kind of creepy. Like, they're not making a sound, they're just sitting here. Not really living much of a life. I think I have to go that way, yeah. Oh, thank God you can jump like Jordan. So what I think these nodes are is, there's like points of control around the world. I mean, I don't know if this is true. This is just my own like head theory. That there's points of control all around the world to keep everything sort of in check, to monitor everything, to keep an eye on things, to keep things like within boundaries. And the government probably put these everywhere. Or the other side of that is, which is probably more likely, is that the person who made that bunker made these to observe locations. They put them in secret places so people wouldn't find them, so they put them in different areas to observe, like, mind control, the area, the people, the government, the company, whatever's doing all of this stuff. Just to kind of keep tracks of things, to do their own experiments to see how they can subvert that control. Oh, do I not go out here? I thought I did. Sorry, pigs, you're gonna have to stay here a little while longer because I can't save you. I don't even know if I can save myself at this point. Sorry, I broke my legs. I just love that sense of mystery. It's always been my favorite type of storytelling, which I know, shocker. But being able to like piece things together and have people theorize stuff and come up with your own things and having multiple versions of the same story, and that's just cool. I like that a lot. So that's why I like doing it with my own type of storytelling as well. Because you, all of you guys at home, you're storytellers, you just don't know it. So if I can give you like the bare bones of something and kind of tease it out, like eventually I will give answers to all my ego stuff and Iris and things like that. But if I tease it out more and you guys get to come up with your own theories and logic and you can like get to figure out the world on your own, even if what I make is not what you expected, you have another version in your head that you made yourself that could be better for your own tastes and your own subjective nature. And that's what I like. When you start giving over all the answers too quick, then people don't have time to think and figure things out on their own. Oh god, you scared me. Again, I've played this game a lot, but I'm so distracted now when I play it on my own, I'm like so locked in, but when you do a let's play, it's very different. Come on, piggy! He has the worm in him as well. That's why he's acting crazy. See, even the sound design on the pig is great. Oh, so gross. It has like little slug antenna. Do you see that? Or maybe it's like a proboscis, like a little mouth. But even the details here, like you pull that worm off, it wriggles a little bit, but like blood and goop comes out of it. That's a lot of detail. Hey, what are you doing to that pig? Whoa, calm down. Now we're mind controlling. See, it's all connected. And it's kind of fucked up. It's very, it's like dystopian, or I'm sure there's some novels that this game was inspired by that, like, the world, the people don't control the world anymore, like specific groups of government or the powers that be all control the people. And there's no free will anymore. I'm sure there's like a dystopian novel like that. But I think that that's such a cool subject matter. And now they're all just complacent and everything's just kind of like hanging around and not alive. Also symbolizing like the animal versus the people, that if I control the people like that, then what differentiates us from the animals anymore? There's so many layers to it. It's such a smart game. And maybe I'm reading too much into some of it and the developers are like, oh, we didn't intend that at all, but sure. Even if that's not intended and I'm reading into it, like, I'm coming up with stuff myself that keeps me involved, keeps me intrigued, keeps me going. Like, all the cars everywhere. Clearly it's, like, an apocalyptic sort of world. Like, I legitimately think this game looks better than a lot of bigger games because they play to their strengths. All the people waiting in line. And your brain is like, wait, what's going on? Why are you guys all here? Like a factory line of sheep waiting to go to slaughter. It's so cool! Wait. Just push it forward and then I can get up. Can I reach that? Hoi! Sure can. I've got long boy arms. Oh, I hear chicks. Chickadees! I'm back! Oh, it's just birds. Oh yeah, you guys have free will? Cool! What's that like? Because one could argue that the player, or the character that I'm playing as, has no free will at all. That I'm the one dictating where they go. Such a neat idea. Because that's sort of in every game. Should be enough, right? Maybe a tad higher. Yeah, I should look up, actually, I didn't... It's hard to look up stuff about the game to be like, novels inspired by Inside, because not only do we have Bo Burnham's Inside now, but the word itself is so searchable. Like, here's a lesson in SEO for anybody making stuff, which everybody kind of knows by now. If you're making something, it has to be more unique. Because if it's just the same word that anybody else can search for anything, then no one's going to be able to find it. Oh, perfect. Nice. I'm curious what everyone's favorite part of this game is, and if it's the submarine section. I think that's a lot of people's favorite thing, that one part where you go through the boards with the submarine. Mine is the one with the pulse. I fucking love it. Oh, another one? See, like, the fact that I'm, like, casting a shadow here, and it's an actual volumetric light spilling it. Volumetric light, I keep talking about it a lot, by the way, means that it's like, it has volume. It's not just a light that's there and it looks nice. Like, it's actually filling the space. If there's fog in the way, it'll go through the fog and illuminate the fog. Like, it has space and volume to it. Like a real light. Like, if you shine a laser through smoke, that's like volumetrics. I'm butchering that explanation, but... why am I talking to you guys like you're babies? I just really, 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 really love this shit. I'm so obsessed with it. And I rarely get a chance to, like, talk about stuff like this in depth. But at the end of the day, I'm not a game designer, so... do I know what I'm talking about? Not really. I just think it's cool, and it's nice to appreciate the artistry that goes into games like this, and the people who made them. Because I've had so many times where people that have made the games that I play, they've watched the series. And then that completely changes how I react to a game. Like, I feel so bad if I'm playing a game that I'm not enjoying, but somebody that made the game is watching it, because that would just crush them. I think that's a big reason why I try and pick and choose the games I play a bit more. Because I don't want to be harsh against something if I'm really not enjoying it, you know? Oh, hear that? That's good sound design. Because it gets you thinking. It gets your brain moving. It's like, what is that sound? What are we going towards? It sounds like marching, and then you get down and you realize it is marching, and then you see the people down here marching, and... oh, it's a fucking masterclass. This is a 10 out of 10 video game. Hoi! Nice. Oh, don't fall down there, Sonny Jim. But stuff still works, like... there's a lot of buildings around, but a lot of them are abandoned, so the world has gone to shit, and we don't really know why. But, like, this factory is still going, there's smoke coming out of that, that vent is still going. Okay, I guess we're over here now. But the guy who did the audio for this game is Martin Stig Anderson, and he's a fucking genius. He also helped with Control, I think, to make some of the audio for that. Wait, I could be wrong. Did he? I just remember thinking that Control had a lot of similar elements audio-wise and visuals to this, but maybe he didn't actually. But he also helped out on Limbo. He's one of my favorite sound designers in games right now. So creepy, there's so many of them. And they're not even... it's like they're not awake. But they're just moving under instinct. Like the chicks. And the pig. Don't mind me, just breaking and entering. So these are all... sorry. These are all people from the tanks that were in the forest. Like, I think they grow people in those. and then bring them here and mind control them and use them to like do stuff around the world, like construction. It's kind of like an AI thing. How if we get robots and they're doing stuff for us around the house and the ethics around all of that kind of stuff, but this is just actual people. At least that's what I think they're doing. Because you see guys later who have construction hats and things like that on them. These robots are such a cool design. Mama! I forget if I have enough time to do this here. I don't think I do. No, I'm dead. Oh, right. Okay, I get it. I remember. I think I just go in and open that before anything, because that's turning on the power. And that person's not twitching now because there's no power gone through it. I think these are for... Are these for spotting defects in people? Like, as that factory line of people goes across, they kick in to be like, okay, anybody out of line, we are going to stab with these wires and electrocute you and make sure that it doesn't happen again. Because that person's twitching now. Which, I'm the only... The thing about this boy is that you don't know if he was born in one of those tanks, or created, or made, or... He was part of a family and he got away and he's just kind of rebelling against everything that's going on in the world. You don't really ever get to find out stuff about him. There's so many theories and ways that this could go. Ooh, dead. Oh, it's so scary. Now I have to be a drone. Yeah, and we don't have any faces either. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, it's 9 movements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And people don't realize how musical this is. 5. Like the rhythm of everything. And that as it crescendos. And you get into this rhythm without realizing you're doing it. This is so fucked up. It's like... Wait, I have to concentrate. Oh, blended perfectly. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It's like these are rich people who are buying the drones. That counts as out of it, right? Okay, good. It's weird that people don't realize that I'm different. It's like bring your kid to work day. It almost caught me. You have some wiggle room, though. Oh, perfectly in sync! You wouldn't even be able to tell that I'm a person of free will. Oh, I almost turned around again. And you hear them twist? That's like your rhythm as well. Oh, the dog can tell, though. Which one would argue, how the fuck does the dog know? I like how the character looks at the dog. Bite! 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 What? Oh, mama! My poor face, I'm probably covered in glass and scrapes and cuts and bleeding everywhere. You come down here. Ha! Idiot dog! stupid stink. Oh, Lord. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, jump. No, jump. Do it. Stinker. Man, these buildings are so foreboding. Actually, let's... What's the deal with this one again? Forget what I do. Hold on. Do I lift this with you, or do I have to pull a switch with the boy? Oh, you just walk right through it. Okay. Okay, let me figure this out. I've played it a lot, but it's been a while since I last played it. Oh, right, okay. So I need this to get back up now. I had it too! I was like, okay, land on this box over here, and then do that box. I was like, wait, I should figure it out in case I'm wrong. Dog still back there? I hear him howling in the distance. I'm like, slightly barking. These, I don't know why it is, but these buildings and this sort of, like, architecture and the way they're designed and put together and I guess sort of the intense atmosphere reminds me a lot of Half-Life 2. Like, the Combine are here and dictating what's going on and things like that, you know? Wait, no. You do that, and then... How do I get you to get into that again? With this? Double control! It's a brand new baby man! So can I... like that. And then this guy comes back. Wait, I did that wrong. That other guy needs to be in that. Stupid. That was so obvious, too. Okay, you climb up on that and then get me through. Thanks, guys. I'm so sorry that you don't have free will. Oh, now I remember. Now I remember. I'm doing it. Oh, my brain is working. Look at that. You jump up there, do that, and then we do this. Ho-hoo! It's also really messed up to think that the things you mind control can mind control something else. That begs the question of how many layers deep that level of control can go. Okay, I think I need to be this side of this. I like the boy still moves when I'm attached. And then they're like, wait, what's happening? Tiny boy! Could you imagine if there wasn't water here? I would have died. I'm also surprised they're not looking for me more. Can't I upset the established order too much? Wait, I need that, but I don't have enough air now. I thought there was a secret node down here. It's like Joel and Ellie in The Last of Us. Hop on, Ellie. Cause she can't swim. But I can, look at me, a little motorboat. He's a resilient little lad, isn't he? Just running along, crashing through windows, jumping out of giant holes and falling like 50 feet into water. He's a mad lad. He's gonna get attacked by dogs again soon, though. That's cool, too. The idea that that room was full of water. Like, why would this need to be full of water? Can't do that. But I can do this. up you get. No need to drown. No time for drowning. You guys can't feel it, but he's like all the time. I can feel the controller vibrate when he does it. I'm very curious to see what Playdead are working on next. They said they were moving to 3D, and they have a picture released from their new game, and it's like a sci-fi. It looks like a little astronaut exploring a planet. Maybe a ship crashed and he's trying to find something or whatever. But it looks really cool. I'm very, very excited for it. I think that is one of my more anticipated games, but we know almost nothing about it. Playdead don't ever talk about their games until it's out. And then it's kind of like, yeah, here's a trailer, our game's coming out. It's coming out, like, soon. And then, oh my god, climb. And then the game's just kind of out, and that's it. There's very little fanfare around how they do things, which is pretty cool. God, I love this view as well. Like, there's still trains moving. So there is some sort of functional society, some hierarchy, some people going, like, day by day, all the time. But how many is the question? But yeah, Playdead doing a sci-fi game? Sci-fi is my favorite genre. Look at all those people. So creepy. I also love that this shadow moves with the light. Like, the shadow isn't just still in one place, because this is how shadows would actually work. Oh, it's so good. This game's incredible. But yeah, Playdead making a sci-fi game with Martin C. Anderson's sound design? Oh, I don't think I'm ready. Get some really crunchy sci-fi sounds. Some warbles, some electricity. Hoi! I wonder if it'll be the same, I mean, I assume it'll be the same type of storytelling as these ones. Because it's the type of storytelling they do best. But yeah, I don't know. Hopefully we see it within like the next year or two. I think they've been working on it now for a while. This came out a long time ago. I think this was 2018 or something. Maybe even further back than that. In I go! It's also clever design to have the door closed behind you. Because now you know you can't come back out again. Ooh. Good catch. Strong arms. Oh, there's a rumble. Oh, it's so creepy. But then, yeah, you have this, like, destitute station that, or, like, train that has nothing going on. I wonder what the thing that happened was that killed everybody. Or kind of put the world in ruins. Because clearly there was a lot more to it before all of this. Uh-oh, the dogs are going to hear you and see you. They're dogs. Smelling and hearing is kind of what they do. They're pissed. Look at him go! Is this where one of them is? No. Ah, whatever. You can come back and try different chapters anyway and get all of them. Piece by piece. You don't have to do them all on a single run. And that's kind of what I prefer to do. I like to keep the playthrough moving. Oh, right. I have to do this. Because the dog's fast, but you can be a little faster than him in the water. Oh yeah, good job, dog. Oh yeah, oh, you know how to swim. Idiot. Learn a backstroke, or a butterfly stroke, or breaststroke, or something. Doggy paddling's gonna get you nowhere. Why am I encouraging the dog to kill me? Oh, those rumbles. Cause then it's kinda like, wait, what's going on? Where's that rumble coming from? They do a really good job of setting up the next sections with light and audio. One of those dogs is dragging behind, and I don't like that. Okay, once more should do it. Maybe pull the bottom board first! You know, the one that's actually gonna get you in the door? He's a smart child, but he's not really. Oh, so scary. Okay, this is it, this is it. Okay, in you go, and drop. Ooh. Terrifying. I think they probably would be able to get in through that, but I don't want to tempt them. Submarine time. God, doesn't that look so cool? Whoever was in charge of camera work for this game, A plus. Little submarine boy. I'm gonna steal that. So I guess he's been down there exploring stuff, and then this guy was waiting for him to come back, and then they're gonna talk about findings and what's going on and research and blah blah blah. You don't see me. You don't see me, I'm just a tiny boy who's gonna steal your sub. Don't even worry about it. How do I know how to drive this? Who knows? It's a bit silly to think that I can drive this. I'm not qualified. I don't have a license. Oh. Here it comes. Are you guys ready? You guys ready for the second best sound effect in the game? Oh. That is world class sound. Fucking incredible. I don't think there's anything down here, but I just like exploring. Being down here in the vast depth is haunting. This area is so big. I listen to this music a lot, too. It's very calming. I love the dust particles in the water. It's a very nice touch. Because water is- water. Water is dirty. Or at least can be. And what have you been drinking? Yeah, this is like a lab they were using. It's like a viewing window. So whatever happened, this whole place flooded. All right, time to get out. We have a mission to do, but don't be scared just yet. Oh. That wasn't the point. Maybe it was when I come back. I thought we'd see the little creepy kid with the long hair. So abandoned. But there are lockers and whiteboards and Things all over the place. This was once a bustling place of industry. That is so foreboding. Like, when I, like this, I think the reason that this is so good and so artistic is because as soon as I see that window, I get like a reaction. Something goes on in my head to think something's gonna like come right up close to that window. And the fact that it's slightly obscured and you can't see the whole thing is really scary. Wait, should I have done that? Boonk, boonk. Nice. We survived another day. We're not gonna die, kid. Have I died already? No, I don't think I have. We'll go this whole playthrough without dying. Guaranteed. I promise you that. Shouldn't make any promises to people. Which means I'm gonna break them. Yeah, this is cool. It's kind of like a simulation of that forest I was in, like they're growing people here too. Because there's trees there, but those ain't real trees. Not out in the outside world. Is there anything further up here? There's more tanks. No tanks. And I love this sound design as well, because it's like you can say a lot with very little. Woo-hee! Those are the things that always remind me of the cores from Portal. Yeah, so is this overgrowth by design, or is it just a product of it being abandoned for so long? I actually don't know. Cool. Oh wait, I can't get out of there. I think this is where I see them. Oh man, that's creepy. This is one of those games that when I played it, I was so sad there wasn't more stuff like this. Like I couldn't find movies like this or other games that were exactly like this or the same sort of like themings. I mean, Limbo of course is made by the same people, but it doesn't have the same atmosphere that this one does. My god, the board splinters so much. They do such a good job of adding small details everywhere. Oh. Is that a yellow that I'm seeing? Yes, it is. Oh, but how do I get in there? I can't just get out of the sub here. And that's way too far to swim down. Do I empty water in this area? No. How do I get there? Oh no, that closes! Dang it! Well, there's one missed. Why didn't I just try to go down? I'm doing that again. Where am I? No, I don't need to go further. There. I didn't need to- all I had to do was go down with the submarine. Why did I think I had to go through it as the boy? That's so silly. My brain has not been firing lately. It's been a long month. Traveling quite a bit. Doing Thankmas, doing a bunch of other events when I was in LA, and then coming back and being jet lagged for like a week. They say if you're jet lagged, it takes a day for every hour of time difference where you were. So we, it's 8 hour time difference to LA, so it's, people say, oh, it'll be... Where do you go? Can I put you in the submarine? Oh my god. I do not remember this. What if he just steals it? But you can't reach that though. I don't remember this node at all. Oh, no, get in. Can you get in? There you go. Like, unless you do that, I guess, but I don't think that's gonna work. What do I do? Wait, hold on. Maybe if I do this. And then I use the sub? Yeah! Wow! I don't remember ever getting that one. That's a wild one. Ooh, look at the big orb in the back. Interesting. And if you notice, when you pull out that thing, the mind control stops. I think that's important to try and figure out what those things are. It's all about cutting the control of everything. But who knows who left them there? Maybe that person's dead. God, what a cool game. So atmospheric, so mysterious. Okay, now we can do this. If I remember correctly, is going down to hit this button, then the water lowers? Yeah. Which is good, because otherwise I'd drown. Can you... Why are you not getting onto this sometimes? Oh, I need the water to be higher. Because I need to shoot the submarine over that, I think. And then I come back and do this. I'm getting ahead of myself! Does it raise it enough? Oh, it surely does. Oh, I don't even have to, like, get it out over it. I can just swim it out over it. Well, that's much easier. That sound. It's like a... Like a hissing, fuzzy kind of noise. Maybe it's the sound of mind control! The way the water pierces the light and the water shader and everything. Oh, sorry, I'm probably getting really annoying talking about it over and over and over and over again. I just love video games so much. I love how they're made. I love the techniques people use to get around things and like whatever artistic kind of vision they have. There's a bunch of tricks you can do to get it. Like, the whole thing is just problem-solving. Nice. That's so fun to do. Further into the complex we go! Yeah, back away! Back away! I don't care how nice your hair is. Just back away, okay? Back away! This building, this part of the building is very reminiscent to where you end the game at, actually. Okay, you stay there. Oh! God, I'm intelligent. If only they were intelligent, they'd be able to kill me easier. But they're not, they're idiots. Hold on, broke my submarine. I'm an idiot as well. Whee! This is so bizarre though. This is outside. And right below me is like stairs and parts of the building and everything. Was the building just built into the ground? All buildings are built into the ground, but you know what I mean. Can I break this? Sure can. One more! Nice. I think this is where another node is. I think we've missed like one or two so far. Not too bad. Oh, you put tape on the wall? How is that going to help anything? You see the tree behind it. The tree burst out through it. You hear that? Very subtly. Oh yeah, turn that audio all the way up. You hear that pulse already. To telegraph that sound from so far away is fucking awesome. Which means we're coming up soon to the, my favorite part of the game. you gotta have fun in life, you know? God, that environment's really creepy looking. Because these were also the games that inspired Little Nightmares. The kind of style of it. Obviously other things inspired it as well. But you can tell that Limbo and Inside were big inspirations on them. And those games are great. Little Nightmares 2 is a lot better than the first one. But I don't know, there's something about these games that's so perfectly crafted. Maybe it just fits my styles better. I don't know if you guys can actually hear that. Hopefully in the edit we bumped it up a little bit. So you can hear it. I mean, you're going to hear it very loudly soon. Nice. I'll get you out, buddy! Just kidding. I'm a tiny child and I'm not strong enough. I'll be back. I love a good, deep, bassy sound. Not just like a loud sound. Loud sounds are very different than good sounds. A lot of games and movies tend to think that good audio is like just throwing a bunch of sounds at you. Or everything having a sound, but if you... if you have sounds like this... wait for it. And everything like shaking just ever so slightly. It really sells the sort of like sense of scale to it. Hello? Oh wait. I can turn that on here. I thought this was just for the counter that I needed later, but it's actually for that. So I need 19 people to stand on that. Which is a little weird when you think about it. Like, they need 19 people to stand in it to get through one of their doors. I don't get it. But I need to start amassing an army. An army of lads! Yoo-hoo! Brain control, boys! I need my brain control device, though. Okay. I thought it would be there. I guess not. I think this is the section where it breaks. Like, you put the brain control thing on and it breaks, so you just have it. I don't know why I did that. I could have gone down another way. Yeah, I need that. Hey, lads! How's it going? Like, these all seem like construction workers. Oh god, where am I going? Oh god, I've made a mistake. No, I haven't. No, I haven't. No, I haven't. Maybe I have. I can't see anything. We go again. Make more mistakes. Life's full of them. It's what you learn from them that's important. I'm trying to give you a life lesson. It doesn't fucking matter. Huh! God, the lighting. The lighting! Have you guys heard about lighting in video games before? Let me tell you! Hoi! And, hoi! All the way across. Yeah, that one breaks. But I don't know how I'm able to still have the power. I don't know how that works. Okay, you guys throw me up. Woohoo! I would love to have 10 lads throw me into the air to see how high they can throw me. Like, all of that muscle together, working together, powerful, strong. Apes, together, strong. That's us. Just a bunch of hairless apes. Some of us are very hairy. So we're just apes. Come on, lads, we have work to do. We're gonna rebuild this world. We're gonna build up our own empire. Screw everyone else. Revolution begins now, brothers. Rise to the power that will be. Or do whatever you want. I mean, I'm gonna let go of you guys soon, so we won't be able to hang out. Sorry. Everybody grab this. And then everybody leave that here. Bonk. And everybody throw me up here. Ha! Thanks, lads. It's like it's your birthday and they throw you in the air up and down like, hip hip hooray! Nothing that way. Don't know why I'm going that way. Well, I've seen the dust fall down because the thing is like blasting. There's... Oh wait, hold on, hold on. Oh, I fucked it up. I wanted to see if there was anything here, but the guys end up pushing that. I'm trying to get them to grab it, but they're not. Come on, guys! God damn it. Now we gotta do it again. Now we look foolish. Silly, even. Dumb. But it's even worse, because not only do you guys not have brains to be able to do your own thing, and free will and all that, but you're all following my orders. Which means that I'm just silly times, like, six. And that's way worse. Oh, there it is. It was here. I need lads. I need manpower.
Manflesh.
I'm coming, bios! Do you think if I slapped myself in the face, the guys would slap themselves? Do you think if I stuck a finger in my ear, they'd do it? Do you think if I did worse things, they'd do it? Okay, this, I remember this one. You do that, and then you get ready. I look like Toad from Mario.
Hello! You have a brain? Mind control!
Hell yeah! Flop, flop, flop. Yeah, these guys have hard hats on. Well, you don't. So technically you fell the hardest of all. I'm sorry. But hey, what are you using a hard hat for if you've nothing to protect? I mean, I'm sure you have a brain to be able to connect in and make your whole body function and like your motor functions and all that, but you just don't have any full control over it. All right, you guys grab this as well. All right, stay there. I'm going in. This is secret stuff. You guys don't know about it. Oh, deep. Deep, deep down. Deep down, dark, deep down. Yeah, take that. Yeah, if you don't find these things, if you don't really, like, try to do anything with them, you don't really get... Like, there's a lot of sections of the game that are hidden behind this stuff, so you don't really get to play as much of the game if you don't go for all the nodes. No, you don't! Stupid dogs. Stupid dogs! Get out of here, you fuckers. Hey! Hey, 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 hey! Hey, watch it now. Yeah, you better run! Do you think they're just scared of the noise, or they know what's going on? They're like, oh, the mind control is broken. Oh, that flame effect is really nice. I never noticed. That's legit. There's some god-awful fire effects in some games. Like, I know Elden Ring, best game of the year. And I love it, it's my favorite game of the year, but sometimes it's fire. Especially when the Erdtree gets lit on fire. Does not look great. But then again, that's not FromSoft's forte, and this is a 2D game, not a massive open-world AAA RPG. Alright, lads. Good job. Fellas, meet other fellas. There's a whole gaggle of us now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 8? Yeah, there's 8 of us. That's good. That's not 19, though. There's 9 of us total, including me. But we've more friends to get. Let's go up to mid-level. Oh, sorry. Sorry, my bad. My bad, sorry. Hip hip, hooray! Hip hip, hooray! It's my birthday! Thanks, guys! Such nice lads. Just treat me so well. They've got my back, they support me. And I appreciate that. Am I faster if I run? Hop? Wait, is this where it was? Where I saw the guy behind the... gate? Yeah. Okay, good. I thought I was running all the way back here and wasting my time for no reason. Lift, lads, lift! How are you guys doing? You don't even have any pants on! Alright, lads. I know we've practiced vertical jumping before, but now let's practice- Oh, you're already doing it! Okay. Thank you! This one you do... now! Beautiful! Beautiful! First try! You'll not believe the amount of times I've fucked that up before. Wait, there's nobody... down here, is there? No. It's a very dark game, it's hard to see anything. Wait, how many of there are you now? I think we got three more? Now we have 11? That's still not 19, guys. Do the math. Maybe 12? I don't know, I can't count them. They keep like merging into one another and flopping over and... They're just a bunch of weirdos. But this would be great. Having a bunch of boys around that you could just hang out with. They'd all have to do your bidding, but at least we'd be able to start our band. I'd put someone on drums, keyboards. I guess you'd need to learn how to play, though. I love that. Now that you get more of these guys, the music starts kicking in because the game knows that you're about to head to the next area, so it's trying to, like, swell up and crescendo you to the next section. But I love that a lot of the musical cues sound like elements from the game. Like, they sound like what the game would be making sounds of. Oh! Are you okay? They're probably fine. They're probably fine. Resilient. Like I said, you guys don't have any brains, so... As long as your legs still work... Well, that is the fucked up thing, right? That if I'm controlling them... Can they break their legs and everything and they just still... Like, try and run around? One last one. Yeah, this is cool. You get like a little hint, a little peek. The pipe kind of like swells. Alright, come on, fella. It just said I needed 19 bodies. It didn't say I needed 19 alive bodies. Which, let's face it, as soon as I turn this thing off my head. Oh, he didn't land on the thing? I thought I was gonna say 18 now. Alright, lads. Some of you will die. All of you, really. Well, one might argue, were you even alive to begin with? Let's go catch up with our friends over here. Because some of them fell down, but I don't think they're following us yet. Yeah, see, they're just... broken and flopped over until you go near them, and then they're like, oh, brainwaves? Okay. I don't know how effective this would be. Like, do they have the technology to be able to separate out controlling one versus the other? Or is it just a sphere of influence? Because I'm controlling them all at once, which I don't know how you get any work done at that regard. Other than getting everyone to lift things. Listen to that music. Here we go, guys. Best part of the game. So long, fellas. It was a pleasure controlling you. But I must go now. The planet needs me. That's so crazy. It just blasted off your head from that distance. So if you get stuck out in this, it just kills you. Watch this. That's so fucking dope. And I love seeing those things, like, sway. It's like, are they absorbing the shock for electricity? Is this thing powering everything, or are they just monitoring it? Is the pulse a natural occurrence? Uh-oh. Sweet Jesus. Is the pulse a natural occurrence, or something man-made that... I don't know. Is this what's killed everybody? I don't know. I remember this one very well. Oh, and that's not even the best it's gonna get. Cause like, it's a big blast, but it's very muted right now. Fuck yes. Wait, should I stop it here? and then it'll protect me there. I think once this thing protects me from it, now the sound is going to get incredible. Oh! Mm. Oh, that scratches my soul. I'm not even exaggerating by saying that that's one of my favorite sounds in a video game. It's crunchy, it's ominous, it's deep, it's clear. Oh. It's the fucking best. No! Okay, I need to be a bit different about it. Okay. Perfect. Perfect. Perfect! But if you're caught out in it, you will die. Like these guys. Like it's just, it fucks everything up. What is it? I mean, maybe the developers don't even have an answer to that. They're just like, we just thought it sounded really cool, and it was a cool, like, element for the game. Oh my god, the timing on that is so specific. Is it now I can go? Yep. Oh god. Oh, that was close! I mean, that's it. That's the whole section. But my god, does that leave an impression. I didn't even show you because I just did it all first try, but I didn't show you how it affects the kid. If you get hit by it, it just explodes him into bits. It's really fucked up, but it's cool looking. Just shows how powerful it is. Oh, I'm sure this'll work. Yeah, this'll work, no problem. A nice, relaxing elevator ride all the way down. It's nice to have a moment to just... Oh god! Oh god! Oh! Oh! Oh god! Oh! Oh god! Okay! Well... Time to die, I guess! I can't breathe! I can't swim! Okay, why can you hold your breath longer now than you've ever been able to before? What's up with that bullshit, huh? Yeah, close that. We don't want to go back down there. Or maybe we do. I don't know. Whatever. I thought you were gonna close it. Oh god, that's all so fucking intense. Oh, I made it. Nice. Oh. So I guess I do this and then jump. Oh, ho, ho, Indiana boy! Now we're in a bigger part of the complex that seems to... not be in as much disrepair and disuse. Never mind, actually, this is still the water area. Make sure we're not missing any mind control nodes. Nope. Nice. We do this. Oh wait, shit. Okay, I messed it up. Do this, and then this. Nice. Excellent. Oh, there is one. That's so creepy. You see the little umbilical cords coming out of them as well? What up with that? It's more fucked up that they're kids. Because I think what those kids signify is that I think this whole game is about, like, control and evolution and progressing humans at all costs and that kind of stuff, and that's probably what destroyed us, but also is what is moving humanity forward in a way. So they created people who are, like, grown and are controlled, and then they're able to create kids who are grown and then are able to breathe underwater, and I think those creatures that are underwater with the long hair actually rebelled and destroyed the place, and that's why it's all submerged now. That they just got out of containment and are like, fuck you guys. This one ain't dead. Oh, they're not dead at all. Oh, they're very much alive. Very, very, very much alive. I don't know if you can mind control them. She has something on her ankle as well. I don't know what that means. Why would I? It's not explained. Oh! Nice! Any distance helps? So it seems like they react strongest- oh wait, there's something here. They react strongest in the water. Actually, they only react in the water. So I wonder if they can even survive on land, or if it's some sort of, like, electrical signal they detect when you land in the water kind of thing. Nice! Oh, God. Oh, I hate them! They're so creepy! Gives me the willies! Oh, that's not something I can get on. Oh, no. Oh, no. Ah! Oh, you fucking bitch. Oh, my asshole is fully puckered. You need a nutcracker for Christmas, I got you. This one you gotta get a little sneaky with. Gotta get your little tootsies in the water. Get them to come over. Probably could have gotten them to come over further. Oh, don't land in it. I don't know if that's enough to do it. I think I needed them to go further than that. No, it's enough. It's enough. It's enough. It's enough! Don't drown at the end of all this. Putting so much effort into this, the last thing I would want is for you to drown. You're so annoying. Hiya! He needs to invest in better infrastructure. The whole place is falling apart. Can I make that? Yep. Oh, that was a risky bisky. Oh, there's a yellow wire going up, which means there's a node up there. The music's fantastic in this game. It's so ominous all the time. Ah, they're back. They're back. Of course they're back. They're never gone. They're always with me. Fuck you! Okay, there's something got to do with, like, going one side and then going the other side and then going one side. I kind of forget. Oh yeah, and then I go back and then I come back here. Oh, jeez! My whole life flashed before my eyes! I imagine yours did, too! No! I don't want anything to do with that. I don't want little creepy water children grabbing my feet and dragging me under to kill me. Can I do this again? Oh, that's a good tactic. That has 100% success rate so far. That's smart. I think I missed the node that I was supposed to get, though. Oh well. Maybe I can come back, but there's always a chance to come back later anyway.
Oi.
And they finally grab you. But it's okay, they mean well. The music is so cool. What a game. Because at this point, I was like, how do I get out of this? But you get stuck with this thing, which is like one of the mind control devices, but slightly different. So this teaches you how to breathe underwater. I mean, I don't fucking know how. But I wonder if that's how they gave it to the kids before. Hey, the fish like me. This now is like a parallel of the chicks from the start. So when I walked in and the chicks all got attracted to me, I was like, on land, an air-breathing creature, and they were all chasing me around. And now I'm underwater and I'm a water-breathing creature, and all the fish follow me around. You have like a very lab kind of light. You have VHS tapes for the, maybe the videos of the experiments they were doing, who knows? And then you have this blob thing on the right in the foreground that's like attached to something and it's twitching. So it's almost like they were trying to figure out how much of a human could they remove but still control them and have them carry out the functions of a human. So it's like You practice on pigs, and then it's like, okay, then we practice on humans. And then it's like, well, maybe we don't need a whole human. Maybe we can just make, like, arms and legs, and a blob. And if we can control that, then why would you need eyes and a mouth and, like, hair and all that kind of stuff? And I think that's what's symbolic about these characters, that the character I control and the characters that we've seen around don't have faces. Not only is that to keep them distinct from the other players, or the other NPCs, like the other people in this world, they're wearing masks. But it seems like they don't have faces underneath their masks. So maybe nobody has faces anymore, we're all just controlled by something. Look at that one floating, it's so creepy. So that's what I like to think, that they're just like, okay, you don't need faces anymore, well then, you don't need a head. Well, you don't need reproductive organs, you don't need a digestive system, all that kind of stuff. How do I get this one? Can I just go through here? I have no idea. Because who knows if the people, like the people that are being controlled, who's to say that the people who are controlling them, like observing them and like taking notes and watching them as they go through the factory line kind of thing. Wait, I want to try this again because I don't think I tried to grab one of the boards. What if the people who are watching the factory line as well also aren't, no, also aren't under their own control? What if they're being controlled by somebody else higher up? Because I think that's what they're trying to tell you with showing you that there's multiple layers to people being controlled, that I can control somebody else and they can control somebody else. So how many layers deep does it go? Has anybody we've seen, do any of them have free will? This is where a lot of experiments and scientific and medical things happened. It's probably where those water babies were created, honestly. Because it looks a lot like the rest of the other facility, but it's all completely submerged and cool. I'm glad I have the fish as friends. They're chilling. these fucking big, scary spaces. And again, now you get to hear what that sound was. It builds up the audio for like 2 minutes and then you get the payoff. Let's see if I can go back and get the thing back here. Is that something I can interact with? Yep. But I don't know what I do with it. Oh, you just pull that. It's so nice to not... it's so nice to not drown anymore. But I really love how he blends these sounds that are coming before you to make it sound like music, but it's like parts of the environment. I think merging sound effects and music together is such a unique way of doing things. It's not the first time anyone's done it. He's just a master of his craft. I think the reason I am so attached to this game is because I keep thinking in my head that if I was ever to make a game, I would love for it to be something like this. Not so much the mechanics and the story or whatever, and not to say I want to like copy anybody, but just the aesthetic and the sound design and how much of an impact they left on me. To be able to do something like that would be so cool. All right, we're gonna go in. We're gonna go in the wall butthole. Well, we're gonna wait for a sec. These things always remind me of Dead Space. Okay, you can get in. Nice. Now hold on for dear life, because it's about to get scary. Jeez. Those lumps of people, was that like intestines or like viscera coming out of him? Ew! That's fucked up. No! Whoa, you're so close to being shredded wheat. I still think if you're up here, it would suck the water down, wouldn't it? Okay, it's some sort of lab, a desk. The way the reflection ripples in the water. Doesn't even have to be a real reflection, doesn't have to be real time, but you can artistically just throw them in. Oh, that's not enough time. That's death if you do that. Oh, we can get this pretty far though. Run. We can get it pretty far, but I'm still scared. Okay. You don't want it too far forward though, where you can't get there anymore. Oh, I don't trust it. I'm a coward. I'm sorry. I could have gone. I actually probably would have made that, but I am such a big wimpy. I just don't want to die, you know? Sucks today. Oh wait, I have to land on that. So I did need to do this more. Oh, other way. Other way, child. Okay. Now we got it. Are there any movies that are like this game? Because I keep trying to search for it and no one really seems to have an answer, or the search results are all wonky. But if anyone at home knows of any movie that feels a lot like this, let me know, please. Oh, there's a lot of the tanks again. Where they like grow the people. More fishy. Oh wait, I don't do anything in here yet. How did you even get in here? Like, unless this tank is connected to something else, how did the fish get in here? That's my biggest concern with this game, is how did the fish? How can they fish? Oh, fuck yeah. Look at that design. Never mind, I fucked it up. My bad. I didn't mean to do that. God damn it. I wanted to stay up there a little longer. It's fine. It's just a quick puzzle and we're back up. There you go. Now, we gotta fucking launch this when it goes up. Get ready for it. Oosh! That is so satisfying. Holy shit. All right. And away you go! Angular momentum. Vertical thrust. Other words that I can say. Yes. Oh wait, oh. Get ready, get ready, get ready. Hand on the button, eyes on the prize. Nice. Nice and dainty. Now we have two back in that room. There's a lot of tanks lying around in this area. Like this almost looks like a padded cell. And what I'm also curious about is that if you stuck that in my belly and now I can breathe underwater, then why isn't everybody doing that? Is there a drawback to it, or does it just not work on everybody? Am I special? I think I might be special. Yes. Double trouble. Look at that. There are all people floating there. I forget what's on the other end of this, if I need something here. No. God, I love this room though. The sense of space. The way the camera moves and like, looks like it's handheld. Okay. Woohoo! We out here! These ones are creepy though. Like there's some back here that have no heads, some have no legs. They're alive. Like this one doesn't have a head. This one in the foreground. It's fucked. Like, at what point are you just a bunch of electrical impulses and not a human anymore? I mean, technically, all we are is electrical impulses right now. That's merged into sentient thought. They do so well with their animations in this game to really sell the heft and weight and size of everything. Like, the bubbles go... And that thing opening so slowly. Oh, fucking magical. Also the fact that there's... Not to diminish the fact that there's water suspended in the air and there's people suspended upside down out of it. Like the whole world is upside down. Like what the fuck is that tech? How does that work? What would you even use it for? I forget what part is next. Oh. Is this where they come in with the forklift? Okay, well, I shouldn't be here yet. Oh, I should. I need this. Yup. Like, bring your kid to work day, and they're like, look, I'll show you how they do it. Because this person driving the forklift is also one of the mind control people. And it's like the kid with their dad or whatever, just watching on. So weird. Like, just that one simple scene brings up so many questions. And like I said many, many times before, and probably when I played this the original time, if you're able to tell a story and sell emotion without saying a single word, I think that that's very cool. Oh, so weird. I mean, also the fact that there's not a single bit of fucking audio. It's all just completely devoid of sound. Then if I put that here and use it to, like, climb that? Is that what I'm supposed to do? Don't die. Oh, thank God. Like that? No, that's not what I'm supposed to do. I kind of forget what I'm supposed to do. This is always the one. Every time I come back to it, I'm like, what do I do again? Oh, right. Now I know. I'm supposed to bring it here. So I jump up into this, get the box, put it under me here. Oh, man. Because I can't reach that otherwise, but the door closes. Ooh. I guess it doesn't matter how far I bring it down now. What's creepy about this scene is that there's people in the background just watching. I mean, also the fact that there's not a single piece of fucking noise in this room. Which is a really cool design choice to do. Because how, I always think that as well, how do you appreciate really good sound if you don't have moments of quiet? A good sound designer knows when to pull audio completely out of a mix. Like, I keep coming back to that Godzilla 2014 movie, which has, like, a section where Godzilla comes in for the first time and you see his foot slam, and it's so loud that it cuts out, like, all the audio. Like, a sound wave goes out that cuts out audio and then it all, like, rushes back in. It's one of my favorite sound design tropes. This is a really clever way of, like, selling presence. Now we sound back, for no reason. Sorry, I don't mean to sound, like, all preachy and, like, high and mighty about this stuff, or like, oh, I know best. I'm just talking about the things that I'm passionate about, and that I really love kind of, like, getting involved in. Oh yeah, I can swim forever now. And I like talking about this stuff, and I... Whenever I'm playing games normally, I just don't really have an avenue to do it that much. But this is, like, the perfect game to kind of... Especially when you're revisiting a game, it's a good time to talk about these types of things. They were checking in on the lads. Here they come. Oh. Oh, that one just snaps its fucking neck on the ground. But now they all follow me. So the thing that seems to have been stuck into me is like an injectable form of the mind control. And that's why I can breathe underwater? I don't know. It's very confusing, but you can see here, like, some of these people don't have arms. One of them doesn't have a head. One of them is just an arm on the ground. so fucked up. Wait, I think I know what I'm supposed to do. I think I'm supposed to go back to that switch. And then have the switch bring the water back down, and then I have everyone throw me up from here. But I might be missing some nodes by doing that. Hoi! Cheers, lads! Fair play. It'd be nice if you guys tossed, like, another guy with me. Like, just keep tossing guys up until you can't toss them anymore. Before I do that, let me check all the way right over here. Just in case. Maybe I have to fall, actually, to do this. Yeah. As I'm dropping, I need to push it. It seems like the place where they put together a lot of those pods, or at least bring people from them, or put them in them. Maybe they just incubate people in them, and then put them out into the forest, and then... I like to think that they grow people out in the forest so that the first thing they see is not a building, it's like nature. Maybe there's something primal about that. Oh my god, I even have a shadow on the ground by swimming up here, that's cool. Maybe that's what the... that other one means. Remember, there was like a room with like a fake forest? Maybe they were testing on people to be like, okay, what stimuli do they respond to when they wake up? And then they figured out that forest, but it had to be like a real thing. Or maybe, we actually don't know how much of this is like all part of their complex. We don't know how far their reach is. All right, lads, you're gonna have to toss me over. They didn't pick me up. And now I died for the first time. That stinks. Are you guys okay? Oh, hell yeah, here it is. That's like the end of the game area over there. And I love that little thing to be like, okay, something crazy is over here. Like you get like points you right at that door, your eyes go straight to it, and then you see people rushing in. So you know something's going on. I can't get up there. Thanks, lads. But I think there was a node up there that we missed. Oh, that's fine. We can go back up. I have a whole elevator to do it. You guys can't get over here, though. How do I... this way. Come on! Oh, get ready to flop! Ugh! The thought of them all just, like, having no shoes or protection or anything on and just falling from such a height. That makes me uncomfortable. Up we go. It's cool as well because you're obscured and you can't see what you're doing. That sounded sarcastic, but I mean it. It's like a secret. So you can't see what you're doing. Oh, this is the sound. So that sound you have to memorize. And then when you go back to the switch in that bunker, like different aspects, left, right, or up, all play different notes, and you have to memorize it. Wait, how do I grab that one? So I think if I drop, I just fall back down, but there's nothing to use here. Huh. Most curious. This is a way of like getting you guys into the elevator. Ideally, I need you guys on the elevator to go up and then to toss me up here, but how do I get you in two places at once? Oh, I can get half of you in and half of you out. Oh, I just needed to be faster about it. And then you guys can't go right anymore, so, that makes a lot of sense. I've done this before and I can't remember it. Oh my god, the clock that's in the game on the wall is in real time. It says it's 6:03 PM and that's how late it is right now. I never noticed that! Or did I? And I just forget, it's been a while. I forget a lot of things and I'm like, that's the first time I've ever done that, and it's not. I had it in Shadow of the Colossus, where I was like, I've never stabbed the birds three things all in one go. And then people pointed out that I did it in the speedrun video that I did. And I also said in that one that I didn't do it before, so. Look, time moves fast. I can't remember everything. All right, cool. That's one more. I still miss some, but the less I have to go back to, the less time it'll take to get the secret ending. Oh, cool music. Heave, lads, heave! Perfect. What a massive building. So this is the door we saw earlier where everyone's running across and there's still a guy like rushing in. Cause something is reacting inside. Sorry, lads! I'll be back, don't worry. This isn't the end of our love affair. Oh. I told you guys before as well, I love something passing by in the foreground to just sell the space. And the phone is off the hook, but it's still bouncing, so somebody dropped it. And it's like, I gotta see this. Just people still running in the background. Oh, that's fucking freaky. What an incredible, like, layout of a shot. There's like chairs all around to look at it and video cameras. There's tons of rooms like that for people to observe. Test subjects. That guy notices me, but that's the thing. Every other time you've passed them, they've wanted to kill you or capture you or stop you. And this is the only time where they haven't. And now they're just like, you seen this fucking kid? Yeah, whatever. And whatever's going on in there is far more important. So we're gonna find out. Also, get ready for the little digga 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 dig. I don't know why I love that so much. The fact that it actually reacts to the squares in the ground. It's like a detail you don't need to do, but you did anyway because you wanted to, and I love that. Okay, we have a bit more platforming to do. Like, look at that! The light beaming up on all of them as they stare down into this thing that... Like, my mind, it was racing the first time I played this. I might actually go back and watch... Wait, is there anything over here? I might go back and watch my reaction to this kind of stuff before. Because I'm very curious what I was saying about it. I'm a lot more calm and subdued now, but... The first time through, I was losing my mind. Hmm. There's a yellow wire here. Yeah. Cheeky. Oh, this is where where all of them are. This is where they all conglomerate. Oh my god, I missed 1, 2, 3, 4 of them? Not too bad. Chapter 5, 9, 11, 12. 5, 9, 11, 12. But you can't go in here yet. God, that's cool. So these are all the nodes, or unless those are the ones I turned off. But you can see all the wires coming out of the bottom of it. So those yellow wires that were connected to those nodes connect all the way back across the entire level, across the entire game to come back to this. I mean, not actually, but I mean, in this world, that's the implication. 5, 9, 11, 12? I just realized that I kept saying 9-11 in the middle of that. People are going to clip that out of context and just have me saying that over and over and over again. And now they're going to be like, why was Sean mentioning that so much in his video? What could he have possibly wanted to talk about that for? I love this. You get to see it from the other side. And it's like a big sphere. Oh, we're going in there. Don't you worry. Also curious how many people haven't seen this game on the channel and are now seeing it for the first time and being like, how did I never watch this? Turn off this. Then release these. Oh, it's about to get fucking magical. It's about to get real cool. We're about to go off the absolute deep end with this game. It's like ascending into heaven. Wait for this to speed up. Are we good? Whoosh. And I love that. I mean, not the fact that you get stripped naked, but now you're in the room and it's like, oh wait, this is where everyone was staring in. Am I in it? What are you all looking at? And then you see this fucking monstrosity with 4 of the mind-controlled things in it. So this is just an amalgamation of beings. Like a whole bunch of them stuck together. And I think what they're doing is trying to see how many of them they can stick together and control. But I'm gonna take these out. Wait, can I... See the fucking hand reached out to grab me. I wanna see if... He's standing here, because all the guys react. And they're all like banging on it. So creepy. It's almost like they're pointing you to go do it. There's 2. Oh, they're getting grabby. Oh, they're getting grabby. Hold on, lads. And then after 3, that's all they need. And now I have become Blob. Oh. So you just get assimilated into it. God knows how many creatures are actually in this. How many people? And no one seems that concerned until... Get ready for some great sound design. Oh yeah! That's so cool. I think I killed these guys. Now I am loose! Now I am free! I make sounds too. Like I'm still able to like verbalize. Ew! Ew! The animation on it is so nasty looking. Wow! I feel good. Oh, you think this'll stop me? I fucking love how much power you have as this character. Cause you've seen it before, what happens when they all work together. Lads, I'm back! I told you I'd be back! Touch the blob! This is our final form! It's so weird, because it... No matter what orientation you're in, it works. Ugh! It must have so much strength, because it has so many arms and legs to be able to do anything it wants. The way it undulates and spills into things. It's fucking gross! Ew! Hi! Oh my god, yes! Alright. A lot of you who know the ending of this game, if you don't know the ending of this game, take note of this frame. Take note of this picture. The trees, the light, the building in the distance. This whole diorama that I'm in right now. Remember that. Hey! How's it going? How are you? Hi! Good to see you, good to see you. Okay. Does anyone know where the cafeteria is? I'm hungry for some cupcakes! Or a muffin! Anything that'll get me through the day! What is this, a server farm? Okay, I'll take that. I'll eat that instead. I fucking love it. It's like the ultimate creature. Because it's so strong, it's so mobile, it's fast. It's able to work in any orientation. Like, it just falls over, but it just fixes itself. So creepy. How many do you think they're in there? Like 100? 500? Scrunch! Oh, I lost a piece. I lost two pieces! I lost an arm leg! Oh, this is the cafeteria! Is it? I'm not sure. Out of my way, out of my way, out of my way, out of my way. The CEO. I hate you! Crushed him! Become one with the blob! Become part of something greater than yourself. It's so fucked up. You just crush him into paste. Look at that blood stain. That used to be a person. Okay, get this up over your head. Yep. Yep, yep, yep. And... Okay. Okay, and again, again. Oh, perfect. Perfect. Perfect orientation. Perfect! Oh, you think dogs can hurt me? I am the monstrosity from the deep! Feck off, will you? You can bite at me all you want, but it's not gonna do a damn thing. I am made out of pure people. They're like, what do I do? I'm barking at him, but he's not doing anything. That doesn't work. Does it keep going up if I stand on it? Oh wait, no. I forgot. I bring the board. God, bark. Whatever. I have ascended beyond your need for barking. I am better than you. I'm better than everyone. I am the blob. You think I care about your petty dog squabbles? Foolish. You think you're better because you have four legs? I have a million! I am legs! Huh. Hold on. Doors are easy. Oh, no they're not. Hey, could you open the door? Could you- yeah, thank you. Just open it real quick. He's a brave lad. Brave man to open that door when the blob is going by. Bow and kneel to blob. Oh, thank you. Don't mind if I spill. Ugh, it's so gross. Ew. Okay, I'm losing bits of me though, which is unfortunate. Shouldn't be losing bits of me. I need to keep all of me inside. It's cold inside! Do you think that's why? Well, I'm inside the creature now, so... probably because of that. Woohoo! I'm so talented! I'm a juggler. Oh! Just practicing, because I gotta do it in a second. Hup! Like that. Oh, beautiful. I'm going straight to the Blob Olympics. Okay, open this. That's one way of doing it. Who cares about locks, am I right? Set the box on fire, but not yourself. Nice. Huh. Beautiful. Oh, sticks the landing. And again, and again. For the gold medal, it's Blob! Woo! That's so fun to do. I'm glad they give you so much of the game to play as this creature. Because I love... running around as this thing. Hoi! Open! Oh, not on me. Yes! Blob, go! Become Blob! This is what we're gonna- this is what's gonna happen on this channel. Once enough people subscribe, I'm gonna enact the Blob Protocol. And we're all just gonna merge together. Once we hit 30 million subs, this is what we become. The Blob. And then we're gonna take over YouTube. We're gonna become one singular gigantic Blob YouTuber. And everyone's gonna be happy, because no one gets hungry and no one gets left out. We just are. Okay, hold on. Hey, you guys helping me? Thank you! Hold on. I almost got it. I almost got it, guys. I was holding the wrong button. Sorry. One second. I'm new to being a blob. I used to be a child. So it's difficult for me. Is that enough? No, you could have done that if you tried. Ooh, look at my weight just hang. Oh god, I'm a chonker. Like, why did you do that for me? How did you know that that would work? Are you guys just trying to get rid of me? Alright, thank you. Thanks, I appreciate the hole in the wall. I killed your CEO, by the way. You all don't have jobs. Hello? Can you do this for me? Yeah, pull the switch. I love that they help you. Huh. Oof. No! God damn it! Look, I may have brute strength, but I don't have brains. Can you do it again? Thank you. Appreciate it. I'm gonna do it well this time, guys. There we go.
Oh, hey. That's so fucking creepy.
Gimme, gimme, gimme.
They're all just hanging around looking at you. There's kids in the front. And they just lure you into this fucking hole. Maybe it's to test to see if you can swim and breathe underwater. Like, I assume that this is kind of like what they want to happen. That they want a creature like this so that, I don't know, maybe they're just testing to see how far they can push it. Can I not do that one? Yeah, there you go. And now they're like running through the gambit to be like, okay, can they problem solve? Yes. Can they swim? Can they breathe underwater like the rest of them? Like, this is sort of like an ultimate form. But I'm not sure. Because by the ending, there's a ton of ways you can interpret it. Up I go. Bloop. 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 You have so many arms, you think you'd find a more efficient way of swimming than undulating. You just look like a giant boob with legs and arms and heads. This is what's interesting about it. You see these struts and the walls? So this is very similar to what a stage looks like. Like if you're propping up stage things, or if you're propping up like a set for like a movie or something, like the back of it kind of looks like this. And that's what's creepy about it, is that this is exactly what the diorama showed. So they had a diorama of it showing the building of this area. So the first time I think I finished this game, I didn't realize that this was fake. And then you realize that they had it planned all along, that they were just guiding you into this space. So now it almost feels like they wanted this creature to wake up and walk around. And then they were just going to bring them here and test on them here. Like, this is a giant testing area to see what happens. Because the walls are just a set design. You saw the diorama. Like, they had this planned. They were guiding me towards this area. This is the end of the game, by the way. It's so cool. So what I think happened is that they were creating this creature, keeping it under control, waiting for like the perfect time to test on it, to see how many people they could add to it, see what they could do with it. And then the boy comes along and kind of like accelerates all of that. And then they're like, oh shit, okay. And then it all starts happening. That's why they're all like sprinting, because this thing is like finally waking up and it's time to start doing something. And it senses the boy and is waiting for him to show up. And there's a whole like narrative about like always going right as the player, and maybe this thing was actually controlling the boy, which in turn is like a meta narrative of the game controlling me, because it's all about the hierarchy of control and who's controlling what and how many layers does it go. So let's say at the start of the game, this thing kind of like wakes up and starts like pulsing, and then the boy gets controlled by it and gets walked along. So this whole time it's like, I'm technically the blob, but technically the blob is controlling me because I'm controlling the boy. And its whole purpose is to get that boy to show up, to merge with it so it can wake up and start living its life or whatever. And then the people are like, okay, we've prepared for this. Whenever it wakes up, we have like a place we can bring it, which is here. And then what happens after this? Who knows? But this is like the amalgamation, literally, of all of that mind control and what it looks like to have those creatures all become one. And it had four mind control devices in it. Maybe it was injecting the stuff into it as well, like a continuous supply. We don't know. Does this go back to the menu or do I have to go back to the menu? No, it does. Ow! Bang my knee. Okay, well now... Now I can load because it just goes straight back to the start. Oh wait, this is not... I don't know where these are. I'm gonna have to look up where each of these nodes are because I forgot that this is like 20, 30 things, not 12. In the background you'll be on a rooftop with a lot of debris on it. Slide down a slanted roof and jump the gap to a pipe. Okay. Oh yeah, I see the thing. Was I supposed to go down? Oh, there's a ladder here.
Ah.
he's making the sound as well. Maybe they all make the sound the closer you get to destroying all of them. Okay, the next one was 9. Sorry that this is going to be so stop-starty to get us there. I missed one here when I was avoiding the water baby because I got so panicked I just left. But if you pull them all the way over to the right here and then run or swim all the way left, there should be a node over here to be able to get. I knew this one was here too and I just forgot. Okay. Okay, we have enough time. No, there's enough time. No. The game told me I have enough time. I hate it. I hate it so much. Nice. Can't go out here, can I? Oh. Ah! Well, they're probably gonna kill you, so I'll just load to whatever next area we need to do. I'm so glad that you're able to go back, load it, get the node, and then go to the ending again. Oh. This crank moves one underneath you as well. How did I forget some of these? I think these are the ones that were just really tricky for me to get on my own and figure out, so I just never did. So I had to look up these ones originally. But is there a way to go down? Oh, that's cheeky. That's a really well hidden one. I always wonder how some people figure this out. I mean, not just finding this one, because I feel like just sheer brute force and searching around would do it. But... Oh, the node was on that. But I mean figuring out the sound and then bringing that back and then putting the sound in and remembering it and... People have such good brains. Remember when I got this one before? And I put this box on top of the other one. I think you just bring this all the way over to the right. And there's a secret over there. And then this should be the last one. Then we should just be able to load straight back into the other section. Ah, I even came over here and noticed like a little thing. And I was like, what is that? But I thought it was like, the depth perception of it was weird. I thought it was like something in the water still. Is this like a switch I push? Look at that. The world is full of secrets. Wait, do I have to do this to go back up? This is crazy shit. Oh my god, that was a tricky one. Woo! I mean, it is the last one. Boom! Oh, this is cool. There's like a chair with notes on the wall. And now you can still hear that. Whoa, whoa. Alright, where was the... The actual thing? Here. You can see all the wires. Oh, it's so cool! When you finally get them all, and it's like, oh, what does that do? That is them all, right? I didn't miss any there in the middle. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I mean, the door's open. So this is like a giant one. This looks like the orbs you've been pulling stuff out of. Instead of pulling the thing out now, you go through the door of it. But you never get to see what's inside. Just grab, pull, and turn off the final one. Fucking, look at that design. And then all the lights go off except one, and you're like, where was that? That was what we went to. That was the bunker back in the cornfield. Oh my god, we have to go way back. All the way back to the beginning. I'm gonna have to look up what this note sequence is, though. Because I won't be able to know it off the top of my head. And I won't know it as notes either, I just know it as up, down, left, right, left, up, down. See, now the light's on. Okay, what is it? What are the actual notes? Okay. So, it's... up, up, right, left, right, 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 up, 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 right, left, left, left. Oh, yeah. That's, again, like Somerville, where it's like, how the fuck was I supposed to remember this? And now we get to the ultimate base of control. So far underground. I love that there is a secret ending, though. Because the regular ending is still amazing. But the fact that there's something extra that you can do that changes the whole, like, tone of the game. Here we go. So this is really interesting. That's a mind control device, but all of the wires from all of the nodes, or like what seems like all the nodes, are going out of that, and it's on. Because you can hear that like electrical buzz, the sort of like mind control sound whenever I mind control somebody else. And to stop this... Okay, oh, it goes up. To stop this, you just plug it out. And then when you do, the boy becomes mindless and just becomes a drone. And then that's the secret ending. So there's so many avenues that my brain goes to with this, which is that the boy is being mind controlled by that device there. And everything that's been going on, it's either connected to the blob at the end, it's connected to the player, it's a resemblance of us, like, because it's in front of screens. So maybe it's supposed to be a resemblance of us at our screen controlling the boy, dictating the game. And then when you finally pull it out and you take that control away and you turn it off, then the boy loses control and you finish the game. That's what I think it's like a high meta play against players controlling games. And those nodes are like attachment points to kind of like pull you out of it. That once those are all severed, then you can sever main control and you can stop playing. And it's kind of like a symbolism of like, oh, now we're done. Now the game's done. We've got the secret ending. Because you can't get that without getting towards the end of the game anyway, because you have to unlock all the nodes, the orbs, and then you have to come back here to do that. And I think that's fucking awesome. I love it so much. I love this game. It's a 10 out of 10 for me. It's one of my favorite games ever, and that will never ever change because just how mysterious it is, the way it sets up its narrative, its themes, the meta narratives, the symbolism with everything, it's just fucking phenomenal. And not only that, but it looks terrific and it sounds terrific. And the mechanics of it are pretty basic. It's just like really simple puzzles and there's not a whole lot to it. But it shows that you don't really need crazy mechanics to sell your game and to keep it moving and to keep everything interesting and fun and awesome and engaging. And I can't sing this game's praises enough. I could be here all day talking about every little tiny detail of it, but I love it so much. I'm so excited for their next game. I have no idea what it is, when it's going to be, or what it's even going to be about, but as soon as they announce it, I'm day one, and I'm going to do it on this channel, and it's going to be amazing. But that does it for Inside! Thank you guys so much for watching it. I'm so glad I got to play it for you all again, and to kind of gush about it and show off my passion for it again. But any of you who've never seen it before, hopefully you got some enjoyment out of this, watching it for the first time, and if you did watch it before, maybe you got something out of it that I explained, or you never knew about it, or didn't think about it, or something. Maybe, I just hope that anybody who watches it got something out of it, because I always do every time I play it, and it's phenomenal, and I love it, and I'm so glad I played it for Nostalgia Week. Amazing! Thank you!